special graduation commencement that we will be having. My name is Dr. Barrera, and I am proud to be hosting the 301st commencement exercise for LSU here at the Greek Amphitheater. I have to say that, you know, it's always a big thing to have families come to the event, but when the families put on the event, it really speaks volumes for how much they're here to love you and support you. And so I hope that, you know, you definitely appreciate that. And at this time, I'd actually like to ask the parents of the graduates to stand and be recognized, because I think without you all, they definitely, education as a teacher, as a former teacher, as a former principal, education is probably one of the most important things that we have in our country and that we can offer our citizens, because it definitely does make a difference in everyone's life. I've seen, as I've gone through all the degrees that I've earned, my life improved each time with opportunities for a better future. And so just, you know, take as much advantage as possible of the education around you, and that you can make your life better than it can. So just definitely, you know, grab a hold of that and appreciate that. So at this time, I'm going to have Dr. Rollins come up, where she's going to give some remarks.
Okay, so this is a special group of, can y'all hear me?
Yeah.
Great. This is a special group of kids who are graduating today. They started LSU in the fall of 2016. That was when we had the great flood. LSU advised against moving into the dorms, but these kids were determined, and they moved in. They drove through flooded streets to get these kids moved in, to learn how to school, and then Rush was postponed. The average GPA of these six kids, these six graduates, is 3.54. These graduates up here represent six different colleges at LSU, all with different degrees. We're looking at a future doctor, dental hygienist, attorney, interior designer, business entrepreneur, and advertising and graphic executive. If they all open in one building, it'll be one-stop shop. This is the first graduating class at LSU since 2011, where LSU beat Alabama and the Eagle Nick Saban. We beat them 46-41. This is the first class since 2011, that's 9 years, to win an SEC championship in Atlanta, when they were there to witness the beatdown of Georgia, 37-2. These kids were in Austin, Texas, when LSU beat Texas, 45-38, with Matthew McConaughey on the sidelines crying as Joe Burrow waved him. This was the first graduating class in the 1950s to attend school with a Heisman Trophy winner, Joe Burrow, and they actually saw him in France one time. The most important fact, we got the Nat. They were able to attend a national championship game in our home state in New Orleans, with their free Taco Bell tickets. Dawn, did they pay you to say Taco Bell?
No, Taco Bell. They got free tickets to Taco Bell.
They won a national championship against Clemson, 42-25. They witnessed the greatest football team of all time. They have the largest collection of Tito's vodka bottles, known to man, the longest text chain of over 10,000 texts. They've traveled extensively together from spring break in Destin and Orange Beach, senior year cruise, New Orleans Mardi Gras balls, Austin, Atlanta, Ole Miss football road trip, Hoover for LSU baseball, New York compliments of the Fishers, and the Las Vegas birthday bash. Friends could be a continuation of the show Friends. Hannah and Andre have been friends since they were 4 years old. They were their first friends to each other at St. Teresa's Catholic School. Claire Fisher and Elena went to St. George together. Now they're in high school. These kids all met at St. Joseph Catholic High and quickly became friends. The girls dated the boys, Lewis or Brandon are the boys we're going to fill in for homecoming proms, sorority functions, everything. They were just the walkers of town. Luckily, in Miller dorm, Elena's roommate was never around. So they became the Phi Tri DG and Alpha Phi show. Claire Fisher was always the life of the party. Claire Lackboy had the crazy roommate, Sophie. They survived countless nights in Fred's and Bogey's, watching The Bachelor on Monday nights, fantasy football team drafts, parties at Lewis and Brandon's house, baseball games in the suite with all the free leftover food. That free food is so important to these college kids. Many of the flip cup and beer pong tailgating parties, formals, exchanges, late night Taco Bell, football games, vacations, spring breaks, New Year's Eve parties at Adrian's house, Mardi Gras, margaritas at Superior Grill, but the most famous memory of all, the hot dog Watergate scandal at St. Joseph's and Catholic High Challenge. You took it too far, according to the boys, but SJA won. Girls rule the world. They have always been there for each other for every accomplishment, birthday, event, but most important, they were there for each other when they were down or just struggling with life. It's a testament of true friendship. Fast forward 4 years, the year 2020, they're ending their college career with a worldwide pandemic, the coronavirus. These kids did not get to say goodbye to friends. Classes were canceled, have their last shots at Fred's, walk through the quad, eat in the union one last time. No spring break, not even a baseball game. Sadly, graduation was canceled. They do not get to experience the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to walk the stage to receive their diploma. You know, y'all can't come back and get, you know, more than one degree. I have four from LSU. It's the best money my parents ever spent. But let's not dwell on this negativity. They're looking forward to the future, and they will celebrate when the time is right. You've made special memories you will have forever. No coronavirus or worldwide pandemic can take these memories away. They represent greatness and truly are the best of LSU. In closing, don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened. Dr. Seuss. Congratulations to the class of 2020. Forever LSU. Go Tigers. It's almost over. Okay, so we have some of these awesome graduates we'd like to recognize. Elena Claire Bruce. She received the communicator certificate. This is where Ms. Bruce had to take a series of communication courses or classes that were communication intensive, which meant extra work, to receive this honorary certificate. Congratulations, Ms. Bruce. Claire Ann Fisher. She is graduating with college honors from the Honors College. This is a very rigorous curriculum that they must follow and meet and achieve a particular GPA to have this honor. She is also graduating cum laude means that, okay, I'm sorry. Her GPA averages between 3.7 to 3.79. She has achieved the University Medal for Highest Academic Achievement and is awarded to the undergraduate student graduating with the highest grade point average. Not surprising, she is also graduating summa cum laude, meaning she has a GPA of 3.9 to 4.0. Congratulations. Dr. Barrera will now bestow the degrees.
So now we will have the presentation of degrees. Will Elena Claire Bruce please come forward for your degree, a Bachelor of Interior Design?
Thank you.
Fisher with a Bachelor of Science and a minor in Business Administration. Our next student is Adrian Carroll Lambert with a Bachelor of Science. Congratulations once again to the graduates. You can now move your tassels from the right to the left.
The alma mater.
Okay.
Everyone, please stand for the alma mater.
Let them walk out.